fall so fast, I let them go. Domino. Hi everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I didn't film last weekend, but this weekend I got around to it. I am just gonna go ahead and fill you guys in a little bit on my braces and what's been going on with that. So when I last updated you guys about my braces, I was explaining how I started my turning process. As you can see, I have turned quite a bit. Basically, the turning process overall, it wasn't really painful by any means, just like right after you did it. I mean, if you, I did maybe like 2 out of my 20 turns experienced a little bit of, a little bit of actual pain. Otherwise, most of the time I just felt pressure. And the 2 times that I did experience pain, I just took I'm having such difficulty talking today. I did take 2 ibuprofen and it was fine and it stopped. So overall though, it wasn't really painful. It just felt a lot of pressure and it was crazy because one morning I woke up and like I was thinking to myself, what if I don't get a gap? What if, like, are my teeth actually even moving? Like, I'm not seeing anything. And it was just like a couple of days because my orthodontist told me that usually when you start the turning process, it only takes, because you do 2 a day, at least that's what my orthodontist had me do, 2 a day until I started to see a gap. And he said normally that's around day 4 or day 5, so 8 or 10 turns. And I kept on turning 2 times a day and I really wasn't seeing that much of a gap. So finally, after maybe like 2 weeks of turns pretty much, and basically after they, after the 4 days went by, I was a little bit concerned, so I still continued to do 2 turns a day until I did see something. And I didn't really know if I should switch over to 1 turn a day, but I did because, I mean, worst case scenario, I would have just had to do it longer. And so I started to do 1 turn a day as soon as I saw a little spacing in between my top 2 front 2 teeth in like the middle. So like it was just like a little bit spaced out, like the slightest. I will insert a picture here too. So I started doing 1 turn a day after that. So I was able to start my turning right after I got the screws in my mouth the very next day. Again, I know, I'm pretty sure with kids anyways, because not everybody has to get screws up in their mouth. For kids anyways, their palates are still really soft, so they're not like fused together. And therefore, whenever you put the expander in, you'll have to drill it in because it's going to break right down the center as it should. Whereas an adult like myself, I'm 22 years old, my palate is fused together, it doesn't want to separate. And so they did the 4 screws to make sure that while it's separating right down the middle. And just today, it's really funny too. Just today, I started to feel a little bit of like tingling right down like the center line of my mouth. Like anytime I like touch it with my tongue or my finger, it just feels weird. I do feel like SpongeBob. I'm not a huge fan of the gap. I mean, nobody's really said anything negative about it. And I mean, it just comes with the process. And I'm happy that they're separating because that means there's more room up top for my other teeth to straighten out. But it's just still seeing people at work and such with this big of a gap between my 2 front teeth has not been fun. And honestly, just like the last 3 days, it's gotten really bad. Over Thanksgiving break, so I haven't seen anybody at work. And I go back tomorrow and they're all going to make fun of me for my gap. I already know it. Well, anyways, So the gap experience really hasn't been that bad. I do have I think this would be my first checkup. Yeah, my first checkup with the orthodontist tomorrow morning. And I don't know what they're going to do. I know a lot of times I see in checkup and you hear that people get their braces tightened, like power chains, rubber bands. I don't know what they're gonna do to my mouth. I feel like I'm gonna go in and they're just gonna do something, but I will definitely fill you guys in next week on that and kind of how that appointment went as well. But overall, the expander, I'm definitely getting used to it. It's still really annoying and I don't like it. And I really want it out of my mouth, but I know it's gonna be stuck with me for a little while. Still, even though I'm done with my turns, which is great because now I don't have to get the key and turn my mouth anymore. But it's still there and I feel it and it's annoying. I also have my oral surgeon. He made an appointment with me to check on my expander because they are the ones who drilled it into the roof of my mouth. The orthodontist does not do that. You have to do or go to an oral surgeon. And I had to get my one wisdom tooth out anyways because they didn't want it to eventually come down and interfere with any orthodontic work because then that would just be a waste of money and what's the point? So they did the screws in the roof of my mouth the same time that they did the wisdom tooth, which I did talk about in my last YouTube video. So if you haven't watched that, watch it. It fills you in on basically everything that I've kind of already gone through. The screws haven't really been bothering me at all. I just feel them and they're there, but it's not like it hurts or anything like that. Again, overall, the turning experience and everything like that, what I would say to people who are really scared or nervous about it, especially if you're an adult, just because your palate is harder. So for some, I hear that it's really painful, and other people just say it's discomforting, it's just uncomfortable. But my experience was that it was for the most part just uncomfortable, and I did start to feel a little bit of my bridge of my nose started to get sensitive. So if I blew my nose or something like that, it just like felt weird. And if I like went like this with my nose, that's kind of like where I felt the pressure at. And the roof of my mouth, but I'm sorry, my dog just walked in. Sorry about that, guys. So, anyways, pretty much for the expander, it really wasn't that bad of an experience. It is super annoying and it does make you talk weird and funny. But overall, it really hasn't been that bad. And I know that it's doing its job and it's gonna make my teeth look nice, so I just try not to let it really annoy me because it's stuck there and I can't do anything about it. So as far as my braces go, my dog is trying to get in here right now. As far as my braces go, they really haven't been causing me a lot of pain. Besides my two bottom brackets back here on my lower jaw keep on scratching the inside of my cheek. Like, I feel like it's made little holes on the inside of my cheeks because I would always put wax on it, and I feel like it's just because I really don't have a lot of room back there anyways. Like, my mouth isn't big, which is why they're doing the expanding, but my cheeks just are constantly up against it, and every single time that I put wax back there, it almost always falls off. And it's really annoying because it'll fall off if I start talking because my cheeks start rubbing up against the wax and then it just kind of like falls off my tooth. So I've just kind of let it go because I want my cheeks to build up calluses and just kind of get used to it. And it sucks and it hurts, but it's gotten better the last day or two. Anytime that I yawn, it hurts. It just scrapes the inside of my cheeks and I hate it. I feel like a lot of people really haven't mentioned that happening to them. I don't know if it's just me, but it's really annoying and I don't like it. Food wise, for me, for braces, this is also something else that I don't know if it's just me or what. This upcoming Thursday, I will have had on my braces for 4 weeks, so a month. And that's crazy to me. It's going by that fast. And I hear everybody say that all the time, you know, like you're gonna have them on and then off because my time period is a year and a half. So, you know, it'll go by like that, which hopefully it does. It doesn't feel like it's going to right now. My teeth are really like sensitive, and I don't know. I just feel like I can't eat anything, and it's so frustrating. Like, my fiance ordered Pizza Hut yesterday because we had his siblings over. We're all eating Pizza Hut pizza, and it took me like 30 minutes to eat one slice of pizza, and I had to, you know, like cut it up with a fork. Like, I hate doing that. I hate being a fork pizza eater. No offense to the pizza eaters that eat with a fork, but I'm the type of gal that'll pick up like a whole slice of pizza and like down it. Well, anyways, I can't do that now because my bottom teeth right now are super sore. Like, they're constantly sore. And it's not even, I shouldn't say constantly, because if I'm talking like this or anything like that, it really doesn't bother me. It's as soon as I bite down. I just feel pressure. It just feels like weird and it hurts. It feels like my teeth are loose. I heard somebody describe it that way, and I feel like that's the best description. It feels like my teeth are loose, or they're gonna come out if I eat anything that's remotely hard. So I don't know. It has not been fun eating wise having braces for me. I've also noticed that I haven't seen, and I know that my orthodontist knows what they're doing, and I feel like I'm expecting results a lot sooner. And I know I just need to be patient, but like so far, I really haven't noticed any difference in my bottom teeth at all. And it kind of makes me wonder. I know there's like crowding and stuff like that, and they did expand the roof of my mouth, but kind of like how this is all gonna straighten out. I'm just really curious to see my end results. And I'm just very impatient and I really wanna see what I look like. But it's okay. I don't have a choice. I have to wait. My top teeth, obviously, I've noticed a huge difference in my top teeth, given the fact that they're split in half right now, and I look like SpongeBob, and I can literally like stick my pinky nail in between my braces. It's so weird, but honestly, I really haven't. I've seen the progress in that, which makes me excited. I'm just really excited for them to as well fix my bite. My bite is so off right now because they expanded the roof of my mouth, and now my mouth is like, my teeth are like, I don't even know where to go anymore. And before my bite was off, I feel like I had a little bit of an overbite, and just, I mean, it really wasn't that bad. Just the way that my teeth laid, as I mentioned in one of my videos as well, my teeth on my right side laid like this. And then all my other teeth, you know, like lay like into each other like they're supposed to on my left side. So now my teeth are just like really unsure where to sit. And I almost feel like every single time that I close my mouth, I like get a piece of my cheek stuck in like in between my teeth. Like my braces like will snatch down on like my cheeks. So what I always do is I blow my cheeks out and then I bite to make sure that my cheeks don't get messed up. But this is overall kind of like how my bite is right now. Get closer. This is my bite. And it just, like, I didn't used to have that before. Like, where I can stick my tongue out so much. Like, I didn't used to have that. So I know that my teeth are moving. I know that, like, It's just a really long process. It feels long. It's really not a long process, but it just feels long. I'm really excited for rubber bands. Just that way my teeth go where they're supposed to go. And I'm super excited for my two bottom teeth to not be so close together anymore. I feel like anytime you get braces put on, you really don't know how bad your teeth are until you have the brackets on them, because then you see everywhere where you're like all these little dots all over your teeth, and they're all uneven and everywhere. And you, I mean, the end result is gonna be all of them lined up straight together. And I'm like, no way. There's no way my teeth are gonna look like that. But it is, and I'm excited. I just, wanna see it now, but I can't. But overall, Bryce's journey is going really good so far. I am sorry that I didn't vlog last week. I just had a lot going on with family, and it's the holidays this past weekend, so I waited until Sunday today to vlog. So, if you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, I'd be more than happy to fill you guys in. I am planning on doing a teeth cleaning routine video eventually, just to kind of let you guys know how I clean my teeth. So yes. But again, if you are new to my channel, please like and subscribe. Go see my other videos because they're super informative. And if you're going through the expansion, just because I had such a hard time finding people that were going through what I'm currently going through, just watch my video on the expander. It's not fun, but super informative, super helpful, and we will get through this. So, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys have a wonderful week. I will film tomorrow for my orthodontic appointment checkup. I'll see if they let me do any filming. I'm not sure. But if they do, then I will post that this next weekend. So I hope you guys have a lovely week and stay safe. I know it's gonna start snowing here soon, and Christmas is right around the corner, my favorite holiday. So psyched. Anyway, so peace. See you guys later. This is the face of